I'm not a quitter. Never have been. I learned at a young age, growing up with a Vietnam veteran as a father, how to survive. I went into the military, and it further emphasized survival. I was young, I was a young man, and I was into the adventure, I was into the challenge, and I was really, really good at it. They say once a ranger, always a ranger. Believe it. I had my first seizure a little over 2.5 years ago.
The first time he had a seizure was really scary. And I woke to him having a seizure in his sleep in the middle of the night.
I was taken to the ER. She called 911. And I was seen then by a doctor in the VA.
So after a patient has their first seizure, they would go to the doctor. And I think the first step in good diagnosis is getting a good patient history. Just asking them, can you describe your seizure? If they don't know what their seizure looked like, asking their wife, girlfriend, partner, anyone who was witnessing the seizure for a good description.
Lots of patients become confused or lose consciousness with seizures. And if that's the case, they don't know what happened.
His seizures are always at night, so he's asleep. His first seizure, there was a lot of shaking and large movements of his body.
Seizures usually start suddenly and they build up over the course of 30 seconds to a minute. And most seizures are over between 2 and 5 minutes later.
A patient will say, my right hand starts moving and then my arm starts straightening. So it's always the same description each time. It doesn't change. And also seizures happen out of the blue. They're not provoked. So just a patient saying, I got out of bed and all of a sudden I had my symptoms. So those descriptions to us sound more like seizures and less like something else.
There are a lot of different types of events that can look like seizures but turn out not to be. Some of the best examples, I think, are when a person faints. The medical term for that is syncope, and it basically means that someone passes out.
Sometimes they have strange movements at night, and that could be due to sleep problems such as obstructive sleep apnea.
Migraine headaches sometimes can cause unusual symptoms and even make people confused.
I'm gonna check a few things on your neurological exam. First, can you look at my thumb? Don't move your head, but follow my thumb with your eyes.
Okay.
Depending on the description and the physical exam, we might do other testing like EEG or MRI.
An EEG stands for electroencephalogram, and it's basically a test of the electrical activity in the brain. And that makes sense that we would do that test if we say a seizure is actually an electrical storm in the brain. You should do a test that measures the electrical activity in the brain.
When we are recording an EEG, the reading comes out as waves. And a person with epilepsy, the waves that come out from the machine look different than someone who does not have epilepsy.
MRI stands for magnetic resonance imaging, and it's a way of taking essentially a very detailed picture of the brain.
In MRI, we're looking maybe for history of stroke, or maybe they actually have a stroke, for any malformation of the blood vessels that may cause seizures, for a brain tumor, or especially in our veteran population, traumatic brain injury. A patient who has more than 2 unprovoked seizures is considered to have epilepsy.
Most of the time, we can make the diagnosis just based on the history, the clinical examination, the neurological examination that we do, the results of a short EEG, and the results of the MRI, the picture of the brain. If we take those pieces of information together, we can usually build a pretty solid case that this person is likely to have seizures or epilepsy, or probably doesn't have seizures or epilepsy. When we can't make that case, and when the answer to the question is making a big difference in the quality of the veteran's life, then we may bring them into the epilepsy monitoring unit to try and record for a longer period and actually prove definitively whether or not the patient is having epileptic seizures.
This is the EMU. This is your room you'll be staying in for the next 3 to 5 days. The EMU is a unit that we have set up for patients that we're trying to diagnose whether they have epilepsy or non-epilepsy seizures. Do you have any questions or concerns right now? First thing, we apply the electrodes on their head. and put the electrodes in the amplifier box, and we have them try to do everything that they normally would do at home. We're trying to evoke one of their episodes and record it, analyze it, and diagnose it.
So Matthew, after reviewing all of the evidence that we have, the video EEG, the MRI, and everything you've told us in the history, we finally have a diagnosis. And the name for that diagnosis is epilepsy. I think receiving a diagnosis of epilepsy is a very emotionally turbulent experience for most of my patients, because it is true that they do get some relief from finally having an answer, but the word epilepsy has a great stigma attached with it.
So what does that entail then?
Epilepsy just means that you have a tendency to having recurrent seizures.
Getting the diagnosis that we would be dealing with a seizure disorder was really, it was upsetting.
It was more scary and frightening that I was being told that I have epilepsy. There was not a lot of relief. There really wasn't. I felt like I was being labeled. You know, I felt like there was going to be a lot of discrimination against me. And I'm still learning to come to grips with it.
Many patients, when they're diagnosed with epilepsy, they're relieved to know that there is treatment for them. A lot of times have had symptoms and doctors haven't been able to figure out why, but then they come to our center and we can pick a medication that's more tailored to them and they can have better control of their seizures that way, or even be seizure-free.
The good news is that because of his stay at the epilepsy center, they were able to determine where in his brain is the trigger point for the seizures. And so now they can better recommend medications.
I think our treatments in epilepsy are quite effective for the vast majority of patients.
More than 70% of patients who are started on one medication do very well and are seizure-free. If that one medication doesn't work, we have many other medications, and it's trial and error, but we usually can find a good combination to prevent seizures.
It's getting easier and easier to deal with, especially with the treatment that I'm getting. I can't stress it enough. It's very, very professional, and it also feels personable, which I know is a rarity in the health profession. As far as my future goes, I see not only potential for success, but more importantly, happiness. I want to have a good life. I'm starting a new career, something that I'm going to be really, really good at. I have a son and a fiance, and I'm thinking about being there for them and experiencing family. Raising a son just really, really makes me proud. It just puts a lot of love in my heart. You won't ever see this guy give up. It won't happen.